Good win last night against the Cincinnati Reds, as the Phillies have won the game 4-2. And yeah, it was a really solid one. So let's kind of just give a little background. So obviously Andrew McCutchen out for the year, so the lineup's kind of been changed the last couple games. And Hernandez, who last night's lineup was Hernandez, Harp, Siggy, Reese, JT, Bruce, Kingery in center, Franco at third, and Eflin. So the lineup has definitely changed significantly since the loss of Andrew McCutchen has kind of hurt this team. So let's kind of just get into it. So last night, let's pick it up. Top of the first inning. Second batter of the ballgame for the Reds, Joey Votto, the longtime first baseman for Cincinnati, launched a home run to give the Reds a 1-0 lead. He barely got out, went into the flower bed, and yeah, he kind of crushed it. But just barely got out. But Joey Votto's been a good hitter in this game for a while. But he's just not really having that good of a year. But just because someone isn't having a good year does not mean really anything. Doesn't really mean much usually. So for players like him, so he gives the Reds a 1-0 lead, and we'll jump to the bottom of the fifth inning. Wasn't much offense early on in this one. Jay Bruce goes opposite field or left center field, and he had a 2-run home run, and that scored JT. Phillies take a 2-1 lead. I was really excited when it happened. Jay Bruce hitting a home run against his former team. Oh, and then Scott Kingery was at third base, and then Tucker Barnhart, who was a really, really good, it was his first start of the year. He throws the ball in the left field, and Scott Kingery scores. Top of sixth inning, Derek Dietrich reaches on a fielding error by Franco, and then Derek, and then later in the inning, Jose Iglesias singled to score Dietrich. And then Segura grounded into a first force out in the bottom of eighth inning. Bryce Harper's thrown out at second. But there was a throwing error by, it would have been a double play. But Jose Peraza made a throwing error and allowed Hernandez to score to make it a 4-2 ball game. That's your ball game. Hector Neris came in. The ninth inning was a little bit scary, but we managed to win. So yeah, he struck out with Eugenio Suarez. So the Phillies take game one of this tough, well, not tough, but the Reds are not just a team you could roll over like they were in the past. I mean, the Reds are not a good team, but they're easily not like a super good team. But they're still a Major League Baseball team, and they're better than they were last year, even though they just, everyone thought their offense is going to be super good. They just haven't really worked out. I mean, they have guys like Votto, who's just hitting 251. Dietrich has been a surprise for them, I'd say. I say that's probably like their biggest surprise. Winker has just been eh. Wasil Puig has been a huge disappointment for the Reds. I think they expected him to be much better. They went on traded for Matt Kemp too. He was a disaster. They ended up releasing him. So I mean, most of the guys that they acquired have been really, really bad. On the mound tonight for Cincinnati was Aaron Mailey, and it was originally supposed to be Tanner Roark. I actually commented on my last video and said that the Reds just the day later they decided to swap Roark and Mailey. So Roark is going to go today, but Roark was originally supposed to go tomorrow, last night. But instead, he is the Reds decided to switch it, and he's going to go today. And Mailey was supposed to go today, not last night. So I don't know why the Reds switched Roark and Mailey, but instead Roark will pitch today, which I'm kind of happy about because I like Tanner Roark. I'm kind of a Roark fan, and I'm going to the ball game today, so it's going to be fun at 4:05. So let's look at the Reds. Tyler Mailey was just. He's better than his numbers say he is. I mean, he does have some good stuff. He went 5 innings, 4 hits, 3 runs. Only 2 of them were earned because of an error, obviously, from Tucker Barnhart. So one of those runs isn't earned. But the only 2 runs were from the home run from Jay Bruce. Only struck out with 2 batters, which wasn't fantastic. I mean, but we made so much solid contact. Harper almost got 2 hits because he hit a missile in his first at bat, which got robbed by Joey Votto. And we had so much bad luck in this game. Even though we won, there's still, I think the score could have been higher because like we kept making all these solid contact, all the solid contact, we kept getting robbed at the Reds. And eventually you can't rely on your defense to win. I mean, which I'm going to try to word this as good as I can. if you're going to rely on the defense to make spectacular plays every single time, you're going to lose. That's what John Kreck said. It's so true. It worked for them early in the game, and then they ended up losing because the defense can't do that all nine innings. They can't make these spectacular plays like Derek Dietrich that like literally did the Derek Jeter throw from second base. I mean, like, you can't have that go out all nine innings. So I agree with Crocker there. So I ended up losing them the ball game, but they were up first in the first inning. So, and then Hughes came and pitched two innings, walked them better. He was pretty good. Struck out three guys. He walked Hoskins. Perala didn't even pitch a full inning. He gave up two hits, one run. The run was earned. And then David Hernandez came in to pitch an inning. Former Philly. I don't know if you guys know David Hernandez. Yep. Played for the Phillies in 2016. So let's take a look at our box score. Cesar Hernandez, obviously the new leadoff hitter for the rest of the season, I presume. He went 1-for-3. Harp went 1-for-4, even though he almost went 2-for-4. His average is at 250. Siggy, 0-for-4. He just hasn't been really getting it going. He's just kind of not really bad. And we're going to talk about Siggy a little bit. There's allegedly something, an incident occurred in the dugout, it's not proven true, but apparently there was a little incident. We're going to get into that later that did involve Segura. We're also going to talk about Angelo Cataldi and Gabe Kapler. Rhys Hoskins, 0-for-3, one strikeout, or no strikeouts. He just walked, sorry. JT Realmuto, 2-for-4. Good cloud performance out of him. Jay Bruce, 1-for-3. He struck out once. We hit that home run. 18 home runs already for him. And I think he hit four home runs in his first, like, four starts. That's amazing. I think that broke a record in Philly's history. Scott Kingery went 1-for-3. He's going to get more playing time. I mean, he's really good. I think they're going to move him up. His ability to wear down pitchers has just really, really been good. Franco, 0-for-3. He did make a couple good plays at third, but he also made an error. And this Franco, he's in 209. It's just like, his OPS is 300. I mean, that is terrible. Like, that's really bad. I mean, that is god awful. So, what is wrong with him? Like, he just can't find a way to get it going. Eflin went 6 1/3, four hits, two runs. Only one of them was earned. Four walks, six strikeouts. His ERA is now 2.88. That leads the team. Alvarez, 2 1/3. He's been pretty good lately. One hit. His ERA is now 3.33. It's pretty good. Excuse me. And he also struck out a batter. Velasquez pitched an inning. 1-2-3. Struck out two. And then Neris kind of was shaky at the end, but he did get the save. He pitched an inning, one hit, one walk, and two strikeouts. So struck out Eugenio Suarez to end the game. It was kind of hectic at the end. But we managed to win the ballgame. So, yeah, that's it. So let's talk about the thing. So let's talk about the game today. So today it is 4-5 the first pitch. Tanner Roark will take the mound for the Reds. He's 4-4 with a 3.47 ERA. Nick Pivetta will take the mound for the Phils. And he's 3-1 with a 6.14 ERA. So hope we can win this one. Tomorrow, the Sunday finale game at 1-5. Sonny Gray will take the mound for Cincinnati. He's 2-5 with a 3.54 ERA. And for the Phils, it'll be Aaron Nola, 6-1 with a 4.63 ERA. He's coming off a very, very rough start in San Diego. He's just been very inconsistent this year, and hopefully we can get last year's Aaron Nola. So good win. That's pretty much enough with all this stuff. So let's talk about the kind of not game stuff, right? So let's talk about, first of all, I want to talk about Gene Segura. Now, allegedly, I don't know. I just heard this word on the street, and none of this is proven. So you gotta take this with a grain of salt, and you can't take it to the bank. Okay, so this is just alleged. This is what I'm hearing. I have literally no sources about this. I don't know. Someone could have just made this up. I mean, I have no idea. But allegedly, there was an in-clubhouse incident with the Phillies, and it was involved Gene Segura because apparently he didn't run out the ground ball. He tripped out of the batter's box. In his defense, he tripped out of the batter's box, and it was really not his fault. You could tell he tripped, and he couldn't really get a good jump out of batter's box because he tripped, and it cost. He said that he cost Andrew McCutchen his injury, which I don't necessarily agree with. It wasn't like Jean Segura went up to Andrew McCutchen and freaking like tore his ACL. I mean, like, that's ridiculous. I mean, I do not blame that on Jean Segura at one bit. I mean, he tripped out of the batter's box. Things happen. Jean Segura is one of the players on this team that busts his butt to first base, and like, the thing that people did is always try to be negative and try to, like Angelo Cataldi, they always try to be negative and try to look for trouble. Angelo Cataldi just looks for trouble sometimes. So that's what Angelo Cataldi said. You know, he wasn't talking about the clubhouse fight. I just heard that from somewhere, like teachers talking about it at my school. I did not hear that from any radio talk. I mean, that could have just been made up. I don't know. We'll get into that a little after I finish this segment. But Segura busted his butt every single time he runs out of the batter's box. It just had to happen that he tripped that one time. And Kinsler got his credit. He made a heads-up play because he noticed that Segura was kind of slow to get out of the batter's box, and he purposely dropped it through the first, and then they got McCutchen to run down towards ACL. Things happen. Things happen. I mean, that's happened a lot in this game. So, and it's just, you just got to tip your cap to the other team because they made a very heads-up play. And it's just bad luck on our end because Segura, if he wouldn't have tripped, you can't really help tripping. I mean, he was trying to, the thing I look at is because he was trying to get out of the box really, really fast, so he tripped. If he was going to mope down the line, then he wouldn't have slipped. The reason he was running out of batter's box initially, and then he tripped. I mean, it's just bad luck. Bad luck. So I believe none of that on Jean Segura. Now, let's get into this clubhouse incident thing. Now, apparently, Jean Segura had to be separated with an anonymous teammate. Now, like I said, take this with a grain of salt. I don't know how true this is, but apparently, Jean Segura had to be separated with a teammate in the Phillies clubhouse, that led. You know, apparently there are some punches thrown out. I don't know how true this is, but you do remember that Jean Segura did get in a fight with D. Gordon when he was with the Mariners. So, I mean, he has had a history of not being the best teammate. So, I got to hope this isn't true. And if it is, then who could it be? A couple of names came to mind. First of all, it was Jake Arrieta. That was the first name that came to my mind. Like I said, this is all speculation. I don't even know if this is even true. So you just got to take this all with a grain of salt, and you can't take everything. You know, what you hear on the word of the street to the bank. So now Gabe Papert does a weekly interview with Angelo Cataldi. Yesterday he did this, and they just do not like each other. Okay. I can't stand Angelo Cataldi. I don't really like any of these Philly talk show hosts, guy people. I can't stand Angelo Cataldi. I can't stand Mike Missanelli, whatever the hell his name is. I don't like any of these guys. I think they're blowhards. I think they know everything about the game, and they think they could. They think they're so smart, and they're really not. So, especially Cataldi, I don't like him. I can't stand him. I can't stand Missanelli, but I could tolerate him a little bit more than I can Cataldi. Kapler. I think you wouldn't handle this show in a fair and reasonable way, and that's probably the thing I am most disappointed in, is the way you handled this show. Cataldi responded saying, "I'm disappointed in some of the way answers, so I guess we're equal to that." In that, sorry. So, I mean, they've just been going back and forth at it. I mean, I think that clearly the guys just don't like each other. So, but Cataldi was getting on Segura because he didn't run out the – I mean, come on. I mean, Segura, I mean, he just tripped out of the batter's box. Things happen. So you just cut the guy a break. I mean, this guy's always quick to jump on people. Here's the guy a couple months ago was flipping out of Bryce Harper because he was a Cowboys fan. I mean, come on. Like, this guy just looks for trouble sometimes. I mean, I don't care. I mean, listen, I mean, yeah, I mean, people in this sports town like the Eagles. But, like, Harper is a great player. Who gives a crap that he likes to eat, that likes the Cowboys? Does that matter? Is that relevant? Absolutely not. So why is he making such a big deal about it? It's ridiculous. Like I said, he just looks for troubles. He just looks for things to complain about. So I don't want to keep talking about this. So Angelo Cataldi is such a blowhard, so I'm not going to worry about that. Michael Franco. I mean, he made a couple of good plays at third base last night, but it's just not worth keeping him in the lineup when he's going to go 0 for 3 or 0 for 4. It's really not. Put Scott at third and put Haseley in center. I understand Haseley was scratched from the lineup last night due to some hip soreness, I believe. Kapler said he might be back in the lineup today. I'm not too sure. Keep everyone updated on that tomorrow when I make another video. But actually, I might make one tonight. I don't know. I might make one tonight. Come on. I mean, that's just really, really just stupid. I mean, the fact that Angelo Cataldi is just, he's just, yeah. So, yeah, I don't want to keep talking about Angelo Cataldi. So, but the fact that Michael Franco is still in this lineup is just beyond me. I understand he's made a couple of good defensive plays, but I mean, and he also made an error, which was, he just bobbled the ball, but he also almost made another error in the game because he bobbled the ball, but was still able to have a strong arm. Michael Franco, one thing that he has have going for him, he has a very, very strong throwing arm. So he was able to throw the guy out. I forget who was down the line, I think. So it's not worth keeping him in the lineup if he's going to go 0 for 3, 0 for 4. It's just not. Put Scott at third and Haseley in center. Okay? Enough with this Michael Franco stuff. I'm tired of this guy. He's just terrible. So, other news, the Phillies have removed Odubel Herrera posters around the ballpark. They've taken them down, the banners, and I heard that they replaced one of them with Aaron Nola. So, Herrera's done. Proves my point. He's not coming back, guys. So, if you're a Odubel Herrera fan, somehow you're a Odubel Herrera fan, say your final goodbyes because he ain't coming back to this team, nor do I want him to. So, guys, thank you so much for watching. Shout out to all those people at my school who watched the videos. Thank you so much for all the support. And thank you to everybody out there who watched my videos, not just the people at my school. Thank you guys so much for watching. I really appreciate the support. And yeah, guys, 4-5 the first pitch. Tanner Roark on the mound for Cincinnati. Nick Pivetta takes the mound for us. And I'm going to get to the game really, really early. I'm going to try to meet Harper. We'll see how it goes. I might or might not. So I'm not going to be too upset if I don't either way. But I hope I can get there early enough to meet him. I think we're going to get there on like 2:32. So like not 2:32. I meant to say 2 or 2:30. So hopefully that could happen. So yeah, guys, Roark for Cincinnati and Pivetta for the Phillies. Thank you all guys so much for watching. I'm Luke, and I'll talk to you later. Bye.